Vedaha vivinna srutayo vivinna naso munir jasvamatam navinyam dharmasya tattvam nihito guhayam mahayano jeno gato sapanthya. Vedaha vivinna srutayo vivinna naso munir jasvamatam navinyam dharmasya tattvam nihito guhayam nihitam guhayam Mahayano Jeno Gatu Sapanthyaha. Gauriya Goshtipati, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told, Siddhanta doesn't mean is gymnastic feats. With barbell we can make our muscles strong. Those who are foolish people, they think out of our own brain, we can manufacture Siddhanta. People think we have learned it, so we can understand everything, so we can speak nice Siddhanta. Gauriya Goshtipati Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Prabhupada speaking, Siddhanta is not gymnastic feats. So that you can practice with barbell and make your muscles strong. Siddhanta can automatically appear inside your pure heart. Provided you are 100% inclined and very humble. How Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj can speak nice Siddhanta? How it is possible for Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj to speak appropriate Siddhanta? At the same time, we see Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj not reading so many books, Shastra, not learning Sanskrit, nothing. How it is possible for Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj to speak so nice Siddhanta? That is the question. I told you already, you can remember, one day Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada went that side of river to meet Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj Gurudev at the bank of Ganga, Ranichara. Somehow he was able to meet Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj, because Babaji Maharaj usually don't like to meet anybody. But when heard that my Prabhu Vimala Prasad coming, he was ready. Then in front of Prabhupada is speaking, my Prabhu, you have come, take seat, seat, seat. After that, Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj, after some time, requesting Prabhupada to speak some sloka from Bhagavatam. Prabhupada quoting that sloka very nicely, very nice sloka. And after that, Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj speaking, can you explain this sloka? Yes, why not? By your mercy I can do it. Then Prabhupada go on explaining the sloka. When the explanation was over, Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj smiling. Very nice Siddhanta. Very nice. But my Prabhu, if I explain this sloka this way, then how? Then Gaurakishore Babaji himself started explaining that sloka. After the explanation was over, Prabhupada becomes stunned. Prabhupada speaking, how it is possible for Babaji Maharaj to speak the inner meaning of this sloka in such a way? How possible? After that, Prabhupada smiling and speaking, if Gauranga MahaPrabhu is sitting inside the heart of Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj, what problem? Any Siddhanta Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj can kim? That is why in Upanishad we can find Jasmin gyatte sarvamidam vigyatam bhavati, Jasmin prapte sarvamidam praptam bhavati. No dissatisfaction can stand inside your heart if you can get, enjoy the full kippa of Guru Vaishnava and Bhagavan. No dissatisfaction can stand inside your heart. full content, full satisfied, saturated condition. As only possible by the mercy of Gauranga MahaPrabhu Guru Vaishnava, then it is possible, otherwise not possible for anybody. Now actually I like to give you one reminder. You can remember, perhaps you have gone through Chaitanya Bhagavat, Chaitanya Charitamrita. I can take it as granted because you have come to me. So I can take it as you have, they have gone through this book. If not, then what use coming to me? You cannot understand. I cannot expect thousands of people can come to me to hear this kind of strong Siddhanta, tough Katha, because I cannot give enjoyment to you. Also, my HariKatha is only for the satisfaction of Supreme Lord. My HariKatha is not the instrument, not an instrument to collect money, position, kamini kanchan, not that. Be sure about that. I am sitting in Vyasasana. That's why I am bound to speak this way. Perhaps you have gone through Chaitanya Bhagavat, Chaitanya Charitamrita, you can find Shakshat Mahavishnu Avatar, Mahavishnu Jagat Karta Mayaya Yasri Yati Adaha, Tassa Avatar Evayam Advaita Acharya Iswaraha. That Advaita Acharya, he used to explain Gita, Bhagavat, Upanishad here in this Mayapur, also in Santipur. Always Gita, Bhagavat. He is going on explaining, some devotees can come, attend class, or cannot come, that's up to you. That time, it is written there, if sometime any sloka from Bhagavad Gita, if not giving exact meaning, not, if, you know, suppose one sloka, suppose one sloka or Advaita Gosa explaining, but exact meaning not appearing inside heart. Then Gauranga, then Advaita Gosa speaking that today I can stop HariKatha. Then all day, whole day fasting, night time Bhagavan came in, coming in dream, usually. Not came in dream, usually coming in dream. And speaking, hey, utho, utho, utho. Get up. The exact meaning of this sloka is this. Follow. In dream, Supreme Lord coming and speaking to Advaita Gosai, Advaita, get up and take water and prasadam. The inner meaning of this sloka is this. So whereas Advaita Gosai, who is the Mahavishnu avatar, is acting as devotee, he is explaining this way. Then how dare I can speak, I can speak all Siddhanta? I know all Siddhanta, come to me. How I can speak? I cannot speak this way. Even Ramanujajo, Madhacharjo, Vishnu Swami, Nimbarkacharjo, they are unveiling the truth, absolute truth, up to their level. Because they are already giving inspiration by Supreme Lord, go there and speak. But they are also speaking up to this point. Follow. Like Vrindavan Das Thakur Mahasaya writing nice book. He can easily write all, everything is the best of Chaitanya Lila. He can read everything, write everything all about Chaitanya Lila. He can see past, present and future. That day I was speaking, no? How it was possible for Vyasa, how it is possible for Valmiki Muni to compile Ramayana 60,000 before Ramji manifested Lila. So you should believe it. Actually, Vrindavan Das Thakur Mahasaya can write everything about it, but still, up to certain point, Vrindavan Dastagur Mahasaya stopped by the inspiration of Supreme Lord, so that the next seva coming to Krishnadas Babaji Maharaj. And not only that, Krishnadas Babaji Maharaj speaking this way, whatever left by Vrindavan Dastagur Mahasaya, the vasa of Chaitanya Lila, I am just taking uchista. I am chewing uchista. Nothing else. I cannot show my power. I know Siddhanta, come to me. I can write so nicely. More better than? This is not bhakti actually. That is why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was very angry with Ballabhacharya. That is why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was very angry with Ballabhacharya. How dare you speak that you cannot obey the interpretation by, you know, by Siddha Samipad? Foolish. Then speaking heavily, he become humble. So bonded soul actually they need punishment. Bonded soul actually they need heavy punishment, so that they can grow some humbleness. They should be put into such a position, tight position, that they can cry and develop some humbleness. Otherwise, anyway, they are not going to grow humbleness. They cannot grow. That is the main problem. That is the main problem. Whole world on different issue, Siddhanta, fighting going on. Whole world on different issue. I am not going to take part in their fighting. Actually, in a very humble mood, I like to request you all to do bhajan and try to realize what Prabhupada wanted to say, Bhakti Vinod Thakur wanted to say. You can find all harmony. Otherwise, you cannot find any harmony. That Gurudev speaking this way, that Gurudev. My Gurudev speaking this way, your Gurudev speaking this way, fighting. They cannot find any harmony. They cannot find in infinity period, I think so. Because they are busy with fighting. They like to project their personality and big. This way they cannot understand. Whereas I already told how, you know, Advaita Gosai expressing his mood. Big problem going on. Also, I can, one or two example I can give you. It's the arrangement of Maya. It's the arrangement of Maya Devi. It's the arrangement of Kali. Whom to blame? It's the arrangement of Maya Devi. Unnecessarily fighting going on. Who? Nothing else. Unnecessary, no problem, nothing else fighting going on. Unnecessarily fighting going on. So we find manipulation with Siddhanta. Big problem for those who are neophyte devotees. Those who are newcomer, not yet established in bhakti. Established in bhakti mean? If you are put it into trouble, use punishment, still you are sphiksa, like kures. You will have to obey this Siddhanta. No, it's not Siddhanta. Not Siddhantas. I can kill you. Okay, you can kill me, but I cannot change my Siddhanta. It's not Siddhanta. Ultimately, kures, how? Krimikanta, engage people, so they eradicate the two eyes, eyeball. Ha. All blood coming. Still kures is fixed up. This is called Siddhanta. Siddhanta doesn't mean you, on one topic you can make one Siddhanta. I can make one Siddhanta. They don't know what do you mean by Siddhanta. They don't know the meaning of what do you mean by Siddhanta. You give me? Anybody? Conclusion? You can draw one conclusion. She can draw one conclusion. That is not correct. Siddhanta means absolute truth, already approved by Supreme Lord. If any sadhu speaking something out of his own devotion, humbleness, Krishna sitting inside and speaking Siddhanta himself. Any bonded soul cannot speak Siddhanta. Siddha Mahatma, those who are. And manipulation going on all over the world. I can put one or two Siddhantas you can understand. One or two Siddhanta I can speak. One or two example I can give. You go to market. I can give you money. You go to market. You can go to market and get one Padma Puran from me. I can give you money. You go to market. Any edition, what you like, you bring. And you show me that sloka where it is written je four sampradaya coming and you know atah kalu chattara sampradaya is written. Na? This sloka you cannot find. Sampradaya vihina je mantraha ste nisphala mataha. You can find this sloka in Padma Puran, original Padma Puran. But now, at present, if you go to market, you can buy, you cannot find this sloka. That is a fallacy. You cannot find. They omit it. Even in Bhagavatam, some sloka changes. Some clever people there, very cunning people, they are going to change. Because so that we can get favor. If, you know, this population, these people, they are going to know this absolute truth. We cannot get any market. Everybody like to find their own market, like canvasser, medical representative. Why you are coming to our field? Hey, Maharaj, I don't know you are making any field. I thought it is open. Everybody thinking, it is our market, our field. Why you are coming to speak HariKatha here? So low mentality, how they become sadhu? So low mentality, how they can become sadhu, you see? They're speaking this way. It's our locality, our market, so you don't come. We can enjoy this spot, Vani, position, name, you go to some other place. So you can go to market and buy some Skanda Puran Padu. I can show you the original edition. You cannot tally. Some sloka changing, some this changing, this changing. Why? Who doing this? Some people are there. Even Raman, I can give you an example. You go through Raman written by that, in Bengali. Eh? One in near Santapurvan place, he was the Kabi, poet of one king there. His name is a I forget. Hey, dear Santipur, Fulia, Fulia.
Not Tulsidas.
Tulsidas never changed. It's Pakka Siddhanta. No change. He is changing, Siddhanta. I can remember his name. His Ramayana is so popular. There it is written, Ramchandra going to worship Durga Devi with 108 flowers, everything. Ramchandra going to touch the lotus feet of Durga Devi, whereas how possible? Even in Vrindavan you can go, hear HariKatha, big speaker, they are speaking. My 1 week HariKatha, I am, my HariKatha, the result I am going to put onto the lotus feet of Devi Maya. Devi Maya. They are speaking, big speaker. Big speaker. They are speaking. My 1 week HariKatha, the result, I am going to put this Bhagavad Katha result onto the lotus feet of Devi Maya. With this Siddhanta, readily I can arrest them that you are Mayavadi. Idiot people, they cannot understand. With this Siddhanta, readily I can arrest you, you are Mayavadi. You are not devotee. How you can speak like that? Devi Maya is the servant, lady servant of Krishna. And whereas the Katha, HariKatha, is just equal to Hari. Follow my point. Basic Siddhanta you should know. Hari Kirtan and Hari Katha is just equal to Hari himself. If your Hari Kirtan is not equal to Hari, then you are singing material song. Why Narottamadagu singing? I told that day. Gaur Nitan appear in Kirtan. That day I was speaking. When Narottamadagu singing, Kirtan doing, with tears rolling down his cheeks, all Gaur Nitana Parsha dancing. How possible? Madhvakto yatra gayanti tatra tishtami narada. Hey Narad, be sure, I promise you, whenever you find my pure devotee singing some HariKatha, be sure I am there. 100% I am there, present there. 100% I am there, present. Krishna Bhagavan speaking in front of Naraji Maharaj. So manipulation 100% there. Manipulation 100% there. Who is doing manipulation? How? That I cannot say. Because I don't like to be involved in color. I am not any group. I am neutral. I am not any group. I don't like to get any position so that I can take help of a big Maharaj. Oh, he can give me money and position. No. I don't need position. I can speak in front of one devotee. If I find he is very pure, you sit. Come with me in jungle. I can speak. One incident I can speak. One incident, very nice. One incident. One devotee, at the same time, he is a great scholar. I think he was from Varanasi. Very nice. Big Pandit. But he is very poor. Financial position is not good. But he can speak all Vedanta, Upanishad, Bhagavatam, he can speak. One day he took decision that I can approach that king. He is knowing my name. I can go and speak, King, I like to speak HariKatha in front of you. Then I can speak HariKatha, he can give me a huge amount of money, pranami, I can change my family life. He took decision. Follow. It's not any fictitious story. He is approaching one day. A king saying, come on, king mean? I mean big jamindar, like. Come on, a sub-king, okay. Come on, why, what reason? Kaise kaise ana pada Hindi? How you are coming? What reason? Oh, actually I come to meet you. Why? But actually you are nice devotee. I like to recite Bhagavatam in front of you. Very nice so that you can hear. Because I know you are very interested. King looking at him. King is also devotee. Not that he is a material. King says, actually, at present you are not enjoying the full kippah of Bhagavatam. What do you say? Yes. Now you go, try to get Kripa Bhagavatam, then you come to me, I can hear you. What do you say? Okay, I can come 6 months after. Within 6 months, he recited, oh, Bhagavatam, nice commentary, everything commemorates, again coming to king. That king, sub-king. King, now it's okay. Now you can hear, very nice, I can speak very nicely. To the point. King with humble, with folded hands speaking. Still today you are not getting the full kippa of Bhagavatam. Better you go back and do, try to get the full kippa of Bhagavatam, then come to me. Then I can hear. What do you say? Whole Bhagavatam I recite everything. Then he gone. He gone. After that, he was just fed up third time. Still king speaking this way. After that, he was so fed up, he developed some detachment. Oh, useless. I am big Pandit, I think I can recite all Bhagavatam, everything. Useless I am. I am useless. So I can live this material life, family life, I can go away. My education, everything is of no use. I can live this life. With Bhagavatam, somehow developed by the mercy of, you know, Sukadev Goswami, or by the mercy of Varanasi Purapati, Vishwanatha, he developed detachment. He gone, leaving everything, with tears on all. I am useless, I am idiot, I am of no use, better I can go to forest. He gone to some place at the bank of Ganga, near Rishikesha, Harida, I cannot remember. He is reciting, now I am not going to speak HariKatha, Bhagavatam in front of nobody, none. I can recite Bhagavatam in front of Supreme Lord. Ganga Devi is there. He go on reciting Bhagavatam with tears on rolling down his cheeks. Follow. Nobody there, only reciting, like me, mad, in Surya Kunda speaking 8 hours, 10 hours, nobody there. Who is going to listen to me? But after that, that king taking information for a long time, we for a long time we are not getting any information of that Pandit. A messenger sent to his house. Go take information. What happens to that Pandit? Eh? Not so aged that you can expect he is already dead. Go information. They gone to take information, his wife and everybody crying. We don't know where gone. He is gone forever. Huh? Then he come back and informing king. This way he developed detachment with Bhagavatam. He gone to some place. Where? But they don't know where. Then the king started searching where he is. Fool! Like comb operation, you know comb operation? Started comb operation. Started. Here and there sent. Ultimately, the king discover that the Pandit, with tears rolling down his cheeks, is reading Bhagavatam in front of none, in front of Ganga Devi. Oh. Then king took information. After that, king with civil dress, very splendid, very, very splendid, gone to him, pay prostrated dandavat and paying, Panditji, today is the time I can hear Bhagavatam from you. Because today you are enjoying full kippa Bhagavatam, I think. Out of vanity, you cannot make any Siddhanta. That day. King also saying, I can stay with you. I can leave everything. I can hear only Bhagavatam from you. Go on here. I can go on hearing. Now you read. So you see, so manipulation going on all over the world. Regarding Siddhanta, what Vyasdeva was saying, what Rupdev Goswami, Rupa Goswami was saying, what Jiva Goswami was saying, they all like to utilize the Siddhanta in favor of their own fanciful attitude. I can prove it. Or I can stop my HariKatha forever. What happens? I can stop and go away. I am not going to fight with anybody. Better I can stop. But out of HariKatha, I am not going to get money from you. I have no interest. I can stop HariKatha. It's good. Who is going to fight? Life is very short. Better I can go and do Harinam and leave my body. This final decision I can take. This is the point. So Padma Purans, Kadva Purans, even Bhagavatam, you can find some changes in Siddhanta. Who changing? How changing? I cannot show. Long ago, maybe 1996 or 98, I forget. One big Acharya, Vaishnava Acharya, is going to do Brajamandal Parikram. That time he reached with full troops, thousands of devotees, reaching where? Terikadam. You heard Terikadam? Terikadam, where Rupa Goswami used to do bhajan. Rupa Goswami used to do bhajan. There he reaches, doing, speaking HariKatha. Then the devotees asking, there in wall, two sloka, very nice two sloka, Vipralamba sloka. You write, Gurudev? He's speaking, yes, I write. I write. They say, oh, you are so great. Among all those audience, one lady, almost young, 35, 38, he stand up with angry attitude. He's speaking, you write these two sloks? My Gurudev writing this sloka. You speak, you write? This way, big fighting going on. That lady gone from that place. With angry attitude. But whereas before starting Bhagavatam, what is the instruction given by Brahma, I can discuss next day. Next day, what Brahma giving caution? Brahma giving caution before starting Bhagavat in front of Narad. Narad, you must be careful before reciting Bhagavatam. So that all population, those who are going to hear, they can get maximum, most benefit, bhakti. Yatha harau bhagavati. They can develop bhakti. You will have to explain, you have to promise. You touch Bhagavatam, you touch Salagram. If you misuse this Bhagavatam and Salagram, you are going to hell forever. Be careful. Forever. Nobody can misuse you. Be careful. As it is, you are allowed to speak. You are allowed to start Bhagavatam with this resolution in Vyasasan. Oh, Vyasasan, I promise. With this resolution, I am going to start explaining Bhagavatam that so that I can give bhakti, I can get bhakti, I can distribute bhakti. No other cause, secret cause should be there. The main problem here. Thousands of people, they are misguided. He is speaking ba 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 ba, he is speaking ba 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 ba. Whom to attain? How to reconcile? That's a big problem. Big problem. One or two issue I can speak. Details I can discuss after Nishinga Chaudhasi. Today, one by one, I like to discuss by the mercy of all Guru Varga. First of all, I like to pray to all devotees all over the world, or maybe Brahmanda, so that they excuse me. If any mistake, they can approach me and speak, Maharaj. They can put question. But they cannot fight. They have no scope to fight. Because I am the dog of Guru Varga. It is my duty to establish the interest of my Guru Varga. So, it is my duty. What to do? I am discharging my duty. You can discharge your duty. What is your duty? You can do yourself. Follow what I mean to say. Big fighting going on. You can go to. I don't allow any devotee to run like mad. When they are going to Vrindavan, don't go. Sit here. Do bhajan. When they want to like to go here and there, sit here and do bhajan. Why, Maharaj? You can die. Why? How we can die? Yes. That's why Narottama Thakur to give us indication speaking. That's why Narottama Thakur speaking, indication, giving indication. Tirtha yatra parishram. Very nicely speaking, Narottama Thakur. Kirtan, show that I can sit peacefully in front of Guru Vaishnava and hear HariKatha. Through HariKatha I can see Vrindavan, everything. Why Prabodhananda Saraswati path not even, not even one time in his life, not coming to Navadwip, Dham, physically. But he is so writing so many things about Navadvip Dham. Swarup Gosai in his whole life not going to Vrindavan, where he is writing everything about Vrindavan. How is that possible? You speak to me? How is possible? Where is the dawn? Never gone. That is the fallacy. That's why Narottama Thakur speaking, Tirtha Yatra Parishram Sakali Munirbham Sarva Chiddhi Govinda Charan. Sarva Siddhi Guru Charan. Sad Guru Charan. The meaning of this sloka, you know? Prem Bhakti Chandika, Parthana Prem Bhakti Chandika. Tirtha Yatra, if I go for different pilgrimage, start traveling, is useless. Don't take travel. It's kalikal. Foolish, you can lose everything. Whatever bhakti you have, you are going to lose. Not going to get one drop of bhakti. Tirthayatra parishram. What is the actual reason of tirthayatra? To get bhakti. If at all you are not going to get bhakti, what use? Because in Padma Puran Bhagavad glorification, it is written, in all tirtha, pilgrimage, is full of, all arrogant people, full of all gunda, hooligan. They are not sadhu. They are having jata, red claw. Yes. I can take bath first. If you don't allow, I can kill you. You can go and watch on TV. I am not watching newspaper, TV, nothing, email, nothing. I am totally off from this world. I don't know what is happening all over the world. Whatever information I'm getting from Gurudev, Guru Varga, that's all. You can go. Kumbh Mela. They are killing. Police, military there. They cannot do anything. What reason? That team wanted to take bath first. That is the reason, nothing else. With, trident. Blood coming out. So in Ganga. Gone. Police standing. Cannot do anything. They are Naga Sannyasi. If you call, they can kill you. This is the situation. They are killing out of nothing, without any reason. That is the reason. Follow, this is the condition at present. So, Tirtha Yatha Purusham, you are going to Tirtha, it is written the meaning of Tirtha mean, you are going to get Bhakti. Tirtha mean, Tirthatana, you are going to Tirtha to get the association of Sadhu, can change your life, mood, everything. That's why you are going to, if you are at all not going to get that scope, why you are taking trouble to go and spend 1 lakh money? Flight fare, this, that, unnecessary, you are wasting your money. That's why Narottama Thakur giving indication. Now you go to Vrindavan, there is big fighting going on. All different issue. About Swami Maharaj Ji is getting, you know, Gopi Bab or Sakya Bab. What is? He is my Guru Bhargava. He is blessing me. If he is Sakharasa or Madhurasa, it's up to him. Why should he fight with this point? Anyway, I am going to get big blessing from you. Hello? Somebody is speaking in front of Prabhupada. Prabhupada, you meet Supreme Lord? Prabhupada, what it concern to you? I meet Supreme Lord or not meeting Supreme Lord? You like to meet? You come to me. I can show you the way. It's a big fighting. Regarding Radha Rasa or Sudhanidhi, they are big fighting. They are Ballabh Sampradaya, they are Sampradaya, I cannot speak this way. They are speaking Radha Rasa written by our Harivansa Ji. At the age of 6 months, huh? 6 months, when he is crawling, not even crawling. That time he is compiling Radha Rasa Sudhanidhi. And those foolish Gauriya devotees, they are hearing it. Huh? Plain answer. Okay, if you are at all going to put this argument, that Radha Rasa Sudhanidhi written by Harivansa Ji, well, you can bring one or two more books so that we can tally, we can find. But you are only speaking this is Radha Rasa Sudhanidhi written by? Where are Radha Rasa Sudhanidhi already written by? Prabodhananda Saraswati. The great. But they demand, no? Prabodhananda Saraswati having good relation with Harivamsaji. He gave him this book to read. Then after that somehow it was not printed. That after that they demand, actually Harivamsaji is not speaking. They are speaking. It is written by him. This kind of fitting. Follow? This way big fighting going on. All around the world. Big fighting going on, big speaker, they are speaking. That Prabodhananda, Prakashananda, all same. One by one, never mind, with humble attitude, I like to represent this. One by one, Siddhanta, about sannyas, Gauriya, in Gauriya Math, they are taking sannyas, those were Sahajiya Babaji, they are always criticizing. So I already give you answer in books. So I think HariKatha is more perfect. HariKatha, maximum people can know. Follow. So about one topics I like to discuss. If any mistake, you can show me. I can confess. First of all, I write this book actually 10 years back. By Sahajiya, are you Gauriya? In this name, actually, four or fifth type of books published. In this name. Bhai Sahajiya, Ho Bhai Sahajiya, are you Gauriya? How you are speaking this way? This is the heading. In this book, actually, in Parichista, I mean appendix, I already give the evidence of Prabhupada. What Prabhupada want to speak. I give the commentary of Prabhupada also, here. Yeah, I compiled it as 10 years back, maybe. More than that, actually. So it is written, the date here. 2008, it was completed. March, Gaur Purnim. So long ago. So here actually, first point is that, how you can speak? Big fighting going on. Big fighting, everybody there, big speaker, they're speaking. Prakashananda, Prabodhananda, same. Samlal Hakim, one big writer, is speaking all rubbish against Gauriya Math, again rubbish against this Siddhanta. Follow? One big writer, Gauriya philosophy, With him, Gauriya Maharaj had some case, litigation. He was defeated, writing volumes of book. He writing Prabodhananda Prakashananda same. Radhakunda Gosaiji, he is speaking all the same. Radhakunda Prakashananda Prabodhananda all same. What to speak? Our revered, respectable, you know, Babaji Maharaj, Haridas Babaji, is the great who is compiling Gauriya Vaishnava Vidhan. I also find there, he is giving assumption that Prakashananda, Prabhupad same, writing this way. I was shocked to see. He's a great. He used to stay in Bhagavad Gauriya Math and compile. Weak sadhu. He is speaking this. Bhaktamal from different place published. They are speaking same. But Bhakti Vinod Thakur never speak, Prabhupad never speak. Only I like to hear Prabhupad. I like to hear Prabhupad. I like to hear Prabhupad. No, I know manipulation. Maybe HariKatha is there, took change some place and said this Siddhanta is this. Many such case I can show you. Many such case. So, first of all, it is my request that can you prove that Prakashananda Prabhupadananda is the same man? Can you prove Prakashananda Prabhupadananda is the same? How? First of all, actually, Prakashananda is Mayavadi. One by one, it will take long time, but I can speak in short, in gist. Actually, Prakashananda is Mayavadi. He is residing in Vrindavan. He is a Mayavadi guru of thousands of devotees, 10,000, it is written. He developed Kushto leprosy in his body. He developed leprosy in his body. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, when doing this Navadwip Lila, why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu doing Navadwip Lila? That time, one day, in Murari Gupta house, shouting, foolish number one there in Varanasi, Prakashananda, he is explaining Vedanta. He liked to establish in a formless Brahma. I developed Kushto. He developed, you know, leprosy in his body. Still he is not going to confess. My body is transcendental. Everything there he want to prove. I have no hand, leg, nothing. He developed Kushto, the leprosy. Still he is not going to change his decision. Long ago. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took birth? When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took birth? When? Nobody can speak. They like to jump to Ujjal Nilmoni. Huh? Nobody can speak. 407, 1407 Shakabdo. 1407 Mahaprabhu took birth. Yeah, first document I give. Huh? And when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took sa, with all data, nobody can cut my head. With all data I gave evidence. They cannot fight. 1431 Shakabdo. Actually 24 years Mahaprabhu doing this Navadwip Lila. After that, it is written in Chaitanya Charitamrita, be careful. 24 বছর শেষে যেই মাঘ মাস তার পূর্ণিমাতে প্রভু করিলা সন্ন্যাস 24 বছর শেষে যেই মাঘ মাস 24 ইয়ার্স গন জাস্ট আফটার দ্যাট মাঘ মাস মাঘ ইউ নো মাঘ মাস হিয়ার ইট ইজ 1431 Sag Magma Shukla Pakha Prabhu took sannyas in Katwa, Kontak Nagar. From there, Mahaprabhu first came. Somehow, I don't like to explain it because my Siddhanta is different. What use? And Mahaprabhu was led by Nithyananda somehow, very cleverly, up to Santapu. After that, Prabhu gone to Nilachal there. So actually, in 1407, MahaPrabhu took birth. In 1431, Magma Sukla Paksha, Prabhu took sannyas. And in Chait Mas, this is Vaishakh, na? Before this Mas, Chait Mas, Sarvama Vattajaja was delivered. Sarvama Vattajaja was delivered. After that, 1432, Vaishakh Mas, Nilachal. From Nilachal, Mahaprabhu wanted to go to South India. Follow my point. All documentary. Mahaprabhu wanted to go to South. Mahaprabhu, go to Dakshin Bhara, South India. South India gone. First, after taking sannyas, first Mahaprabhu gone to South India. And whole South India trip, it took 2 years to complete. 2 years almost. Mahaprabhu going, walking, going. All different place, Mahaprabhu preach pure devotion. Eh? After that, actually, what happens? Then Mahaprabhu come back to Srirangam. Srirangam. One nice place is Srirangam is Vaikuntha. There is 7 Vaikuntha here. But Srirangam is also Vaikuntha. There is a nit yatro sannihito hari. Yatro sarvada sannihito hari. Where Supreme Lord Narayan always there present. That is called Vaikuntha. Yatro vasati vai vibhuvastu. That is called Vaikuntha. Vai mane nishchita meva in Sanskrit. Yatro vasati vai Vaikuntha babhu or, you know, vibhu babhu. That is called Vaikuntha. So Srirangam is one of Vaikuntha. It's also Vaikuntha. Bodhinath is also Vaikuntha. Rameswaram Vaikuntha. Vaikuntha, 7 Vaikuntha. Huh? Yes, all Vaikuntha. So there actually, now my point is that Mahaprabhu gone to South India. Sarvamatajaja was delivered after that gone to South India. It took minimum 2 years for Mahaprabhu to travel around this whole world, I mean South Indian trips. While coming back, coming to Srirangam, he met with one Venkat Bhatta, you know, Venkat Bhatta there. I'm speaking in gist, maybe separate time I can discuss in detail. Now, synopsis. Mahaprabhu actually gone and Kurma Khetre Koilo Vasudev Mochan, in Kurma Khetra Mahaprabhu delivered Vasudev Vipra. And while coming, meet with while going, Mahaprabhu meet with Rai Ramananda, everybody, everything done. There, Srirangam Khetre at the bank of Kaveri, Mahaprabhu finally reached. Srirangam Khetra, Vaikuntha, Mahaprabhu was full of ecstatic love, showing some prem, showing, exhibiting. Trimalla Bhattir Ghare Prabhu Koilo Vas, Prabhu Koilo Prabhu Vas, Tahai Rohila Prabhu, Borsachari Mas, Trimalla Bhattir Vinkar Vas, they are actually all brothers. And Prabodhananda Saraswati Bad, they are all brothers actually. I collect this document from different, I search so many books. After that, also on the basis of Prabhupada Siddhanta. So actually, Mahaprabhu again coming back. After that, 4 years from coming back from South India trips. In the way of coming back, he make there in Chaturmasa, staying in Srirangam. That case is I am going to explain after some time. For try to attend, give attention to this point. Four years when Mahaprabhu coming back from South Indian troops, it took 2 years. Then Mahaprabhu again staying is four years there. Repeatedly Mahaprabhu requesting, I like to go to see Vrindavan, please allow me, I like to go. No, Prabhu, today is actually, now is summer time, it's very hot. You cannot go. Better you wait. Prabhu waiting. After that, Prabhu said, summer season over, so now is rainy season. Prabhu, now is torrential rain, you cannot go. Better you wait. After that, Prabhu like to go winter season. Now it's beating cold. You cannot go. This way, devotees, they are actually, you know, cheating. So that, because they know if Prabhu gone, we can fall down, unconscious. We can know. He is our heart. Heart of heart is Krishna. That Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. How it is possible? So this way they are lingering, no? Making some proposal. After that, Prabhu took final decision. You will have to be, I catch your hand, please approve my, you know, visit to Vrindavan. Sarvam Vatajajo and all senior devotees, they took decision separately. They held one meeting, secret meeting. It is not good to show cleverness with Prabhu. So ultimately for 4 years we are cheating Prabhu. So now ultimately Prabhu became angry. We have to allow him. But we cannot bear. But still, what to do? Prabhu taking permission. Please allow us. Please allow, I like to go. Prabhu, okay, you are going. But how you can go alone? Alone, I can go, no problem. No. Nityananda Prabhu, Prabhu, you cannot go alone. You are full of ecstatic love. You can fall down. All your danda, cloth, where? Better you permit, I can go. Ah, yes, I can take you. So that more problem you can create in South India. Foolish, I cannot take you. Ultimately gone. Now, the main point actually. Then 4 years gone. After that, Mahaprabhu gone to where? Jarikanda path. Mahaprabhu reaching Varanasi. After that, Mahaprabhu going to Vrindavan. And from Vrindavan, while coming back, then actually, Prakashananda Saraswati, all devotees, non-devotees, Mayavadis, rescued while coming here. Follow my point. One by one. Total document from diary, everything. Now my point is that, simple logic. When Mahaprabhu going to South Indian tour, is after taking sannyas, 4 years before, that time he meeting with Prabodhananda Saraswati Pad, Venkat Bhatto, Tirumala Bhatto, they are all brothers. You can find this name. At that time, Prabodhananda Saraswati Pad, his name was Gopal Guru, another name. Not that Gopal Guru Goswami, Dhanchat Prabhu Guru, not that. His name was also Gopal Guru. So I quote this name actually. Three devotees, why devotees? That they are in the line of Ramanujacharya. They believe Lakshminarayan Puja is the highest. Follow. That Rasa, up to that, after that they don't like to believe. The ultimately, now many questions coming, even from the Gaudiya Acharyas, they attack me. How you say, Maharaj? This Prabodhananda Saraswati, this name itself is proof, is Mayavadi. No, it cannot prove. It cannot prove. And now they are speaking, where is the sannyas name? Yes, sannyas name. Then if he is at all, if it is at all sannyas name, then how it is possible that he is going to home to meet Mahaprabhu? Because Mahaprabhu was in the house of Tirumala Bhatta. Follow my point. And why he is staying near his old house? Follow. Sannyasi, it is the usual, try to understand very carefully. It is the usual rule that sannyasi should not stay in his previous place. It is the usual rule that the sannyasi, after taking sannyasi, they should not stay in their old place so that all relatives can meet him. Big problem, they should leave this place. First point, they are attacking me. Follow. Then I speak, you see, it is the usual rule. But be careful, it is Vaikuntha Dham. Sirangam is not ordinary city or ordinary village. Sirangam is uniqueness, Vaikuntha Dham. So, Prabodhananda Saraswati, Saraswati Bhai developing strong love for Ranganath. So, you cannot prove that he was there at his home. After taking sannyas, he is not going to leave his desire to live in Dham, Sirangam Dham. So maybe he was staying in one bhajan kutir at the bank of Kaveri, or maybe itself in the temple of Ranganatham, because they are all acting as Acharya, almost Acharya. Tirumalna Bhatta, Benkat Bhatta, Prabhupadana, though all big Acharya and Sri Sampadaya. Follow? So we cannot expect any Siddhanta Virat from them. Then, while there is, Bhakti Raktakar, Bhakti Raktakar by Ghanasyam Das, I mean, Narahari Prabhu, he written in this book, and from for so many books I can give reference. There is no such document that Prabodhananda Saraswati was there, residing at home. There is no such document. One by one I can show you, after some time. There is all documents, but time cannot permit. There is no such document that Prabodhananda Saraswati was. There is no such document. All historical documents there, compiled by Narahari Sarkar, and all are Jodunandan Acharya, all different books. There is no such document that even Chaitanya Chaitanya, he cannot prove that he was at home. But they prove while Prabhu, after completing 4 months, Chaturmasa, Prabhu want to go away, that time we can find the name of 3 Acharyas at a time. While MahaPrabhu going to take leave after 4 months is over, then we find the name of Prabodhananda there. Also, another point is that, why you have taken sannyas? To get the full kippa of Supreme Lord, that is the only reason. To serve Him from heart, that is the only reason. Now my actual judgment is that, Siddhanta is that, if at all Prabodhananda Saraswati was going to live in Vaikuntha Dham, maybe for Vaikuntha Dham, that's why he is not going to live. He has strong love for that Vaikuntha Dham. He has no material attachment from with previous home. That's why he is not going to live. This is the reason. And you cannot prove that he was there at home. You cannot prove. There is no such document. You can prove that why he is coming to home to meet Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, to hear HariKatha. And that is not a big problem. There is rule that if 12 years is gone after your sannyas taken, suppose you have taken sannyas, if 12 years is gone consecutively, after 12 years, if there is a big problem, one time you can go to your home. There is a rule. Within 12 years, you have no right to go to home. Even after 12 years, you cannot go if you have attachment for home. Mother, father, brother, foolish. You cannot go. It's not the rules. Another point is that if at all Prabodhananda Saraswati Bhad coming to take visit of the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who is the Supreme Lord, the reason for why he has taken sannyas, that Vaikuntha Ishwar is already there. Follow? Why you have taken the sannyas? To get full kippa of Supreme Lord. That Supreme Lord is there in Tirumalla Bhatta's house. So I can break all rules and go there to take visit. Follow? One example I can give from Chaitanya Chaitanya. Many countless examples. Godadhar Pandit took sannyas, Khetra sannyas. Godadhar Pandit took Radharani. He took Khetra sannyas. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu going away from Nilachal Khetra, he is crying and running behind you. Oh, you go back. Don't come too far. You are going to break your Khetra sannyas. Then, Gadadhar Pandit is saying, I like to throw my Khetra sannyas. What use? Khetra Sanyas. I can throw all Khetra Sanyas. I can break all rules and regulations to see your lotus feet, to serve you. Prabhu crying, you are going to follow me. You are not going to follow me. Follow my instruction. You are going to follow me physically. Please, please, you go back. You are the idealism for all devotional field. So please go back. Don't come with me. I can come back shortly. So you see, so Prabodhananda Saraswati Pad also one another document that Gopal Bhatta Goswami from very childhood, used to take all lesson from whom? His uncle, previous uncle, now he is sannyasi, from Prabodhananda Saraswati. Gopal Bhatta Goswami used to take all lesson, education, not only grammar and Sanskrit grammar, nothing. All, everything. Even preliminary grammar, chanda, everything, all. After that, he started reading Vaishnava Siddhanta with, started in front of this. Prabodhananda Saraswati Pada. That small boy used to take all education. It was the usual rule. Before learning Vaishnava Siddhanta, you will have to be initiated by Harinam. Otherwise, that Siddhanta you cannot catch. Follow. Many times I discussed, nobody can remember. In Gauriya Mat, 80 years, 100 years back, some small devotee, somebody is speaking, Prabhupada, we can speak HariKatha Siddhanta to him? Prabhupada says, no, not now. We go on doing kirtan. Latest aerial reception should be perfect first. He should be initiated first, Harinam. After that, he can learn, he can catch. Catching capacity can grow by the mercy of Harinam, by the mercy of Guru Vaishnava. Follow. So we can take his granted that Gopal Bhatt, the Gopal Bhatta Goswami, he was initiated that time in Sri Sambhavaya also. They are all initiated. They all, brother, mother, father, anybody, all family members, they are all initiated in Sri Sambhavaya. Sri Sambhavaya, big personality, big Acharya. So at all, if Prabodhananda Saraswati Bhatt coming to see the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, here HariKatha, what problem is? Whereas Prabhu is already there. So you cannot stand. Your argument cannot stand anyway. At the time of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu going away, one by one, at the time Mahaprabhu going away, then giving instruction to father. Who father? Tirumala Bhatta. Don't try to give your son away in marriage. Don't arrange any marriage. At all, if you grow up, after that you can send him to Vrindavan. Hey, follow, don't give marriage. Try to control this boy very nicely. And give instruction to Prabodhananda Saraswati Bhatt. You can send this boy when he is grown up, can develop all everything you do. You can do bhajan here. You can send this boy to Vrindavan. Giving this special instruction to a spiritual master, Gopal Bhatta Goswami, spiritual master is first who? Gopal, Prabodhananda Saraswati. That's why giving instruction, specially for him. Hey, you can send him, this boy, to him because he's a spiritual master. That's why this instruction giving to him. Another point, one by one I can show you. Somebody giving Siddhanta. I am not discussing this Siddhanta. Today my topic is totally different. It is written in Chaitanya Charitamrita, they are from Sri Sampadaya. When they are getting the association of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, they totally change their mood. Totally. They are accepting everything. They are doing, Madhura Savajan. They started. Even Ballabhacharya, I can give you an example. Ballabhacharya first, he was from Bal Gopal Mantra. After that, with the association of Gauranga Parsad, he grew interest to do bhajan of adoration, Kishore Krishna. Then, Who? Our Godadhar Goswami giving mantra, he started mantra. Who told, cannot change? How dare you put some manipulation and speak this Maharaj with this Maharaj? I can discuss this point one by one, otherwise I can stop my speech. Follow? You can see that after that it is written, they all change their decision. They are doing Madhurasalayan very nicely. They grow. Now point is that, Prabodhananda Saraswati Pad, now my point is that his name was Gopal Guru, previous home name. He took lesson, actually Gopal Bhattu Goswami took lesson from his Gurudev. Who? Prabodhananda Saraswati Pad. After he was changed to Madhurasa Bhajan, unto the last moment of life he was there in Kamban. He took again mantra. Madhura Samantha. Who? Gopal Bhattu Goswami. From? Prabodhananda Saraswati. The previous mantra was not Madhura Samantha. Follow? Aishajya Marg. Aishajya Marg. Follow? Follow? Even this, you know, his name is Harivamsaji. He also took mantra from? From whom? Gopal Bhattu Goswami. From Prabodhananda Saraswati. Now, my simple logic, I request you, you prove me how it is possible. When Mahaprabhu going to South India, coming back, they all, maybe they are Vaishnava at all. They are Vaishnava, maybe from Sri Sampradaya. Maybe from Sri Sampradaya, they are Vaishnava. How I can expect that Vaishnava with whom Chaitanya Mahaprabhu meet, change their heart, after 4 years when Mahaprabhu going to South India, Vrindavan coming back, how it was possible within this 4 year span that who is great devotee who meet Chaitanya Mahaprabhu again become Mayavadi? You prove me. You prove. How it is possible who is already Vaishnava, maybe from Sri Sampada, who is already Vaishnava, how it is possible for that Vaishnava who already meet Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, his heart changed. How it is possible after 4 years when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu meet, he find that man, Prabodhananda, as Prakashananda, he is again become Mayavadi? At least we cannot expect him become Mayavadi. He can live bhajan. You can say he is living bhajan. How it is possible for him to become Mayavadi Guru? Who was Vaishnava Guru previously? After 4 years. Historically you cannot prove. Even if you put this case to court, still you cannot prove. You cannot prove. Follow what I say. After 4 years, he became Mayavadi Guru with leprosy. Foolish number one. That Prakashananda was delivered. Then, that time, while coming back from Vrindavan, 10,000 disciples, together with 10,000 disciples, that who? Prakashananda Saraswati was delivered. It is written in Chaitanya. So you will have to speak Chaitanya, Chaitanya, all wrong, Bhakti Thakur wrong, Prabhupad wrong, everybody wrong. So you are right only. Your argument cannot stand. Follow. No way you cannot prove that that man is same with that. But actually, two sloka. I don't know. That's why I'm speaking. Manipulation always going on. Every time. Kali is so strong, Maya is so strong, every time they like to make some infighting. Follow? Those British people, while going away from India, they make some planning, sir, so that the Indian people, they can fight among themselves. Now this Ram Mandir, Babri Masjid Ram Mandir, oh my God, it's a document. All scriptural evidence can prove that Ramchandra took birth. Even in Yashoda, they are showing in Vrindavan, Krishna's birthplace, at the same time they make one masjid. I have no hatred for Muslim people. They are also my brothers. I can embrace them. But how I can tolerate this kind of thing? In Varanasi you can go, you can find one masjid is there attached with Varanasi temple. This is all motivated. to create problem. Those British people make such arrangement so that whenever we give away, they can fight with themselves, kill one another. They are finding some sculpture, writing. It proves that Babri Masjid was there. At the same time, those devotees, they find there's document in scripture, the Ram Mandir. Okay. They are fighting going on for 18, 20 years. There is no solution. Only blood can come. Same thing can happen in our Vaishnava society. Follow? I requesting all big acharyas, don't run here and there. You collect this kind of small boys. Small boys, 5 years, 6 years, 10 years, collect them. And make one society nice. There you teach them with your character, with your, lightening character. You try to change their mood. Make them devotees gradually. Make one Gurukul, actual Gurukul. Not in the name of Gurukul. Something else. Make actual Gurukul. Where all like Mani Rishi is there going to take, get lesson, Siddhanta from childhood. This is the nursery. Only after 20 years, 50 years, you are going to left with billions of dollars, nothing, all finished. The way you are running. You cannot make any future, scope. So that devotees there, they can become great devotees. Big, gradually. Who can obey me? I am a madman. I am a mad. Who can obey me? For the past 18 years, I am 20 years, I am requesting them. Nobody is going to obey me. Arrange education for them. Take care of them. They can become, grow up. They can speak. They can become big sadhu one by one. But nobody. So this way, you see, there is so much document. I can translate it into English. Very shortly I can try. I can publish in internet first and give you to all. Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada speaking very strongly. We are not at all ready to confess that Prakashananda Prabhupada is the same thing. You cannot prove it. You have no power. Two sloka compile Ashena, manipulation going on. Only in Rasanidhi, Radha Rasa Sudanidhi and one or two press. They indicate two sloka. Two sloka. I can quote this sloka, I cannot remember. That sloka, their writer, not Prabodhananda. Who is writing? His writer. So I cannot speak lie. The writer writing, who is compiling this sloka, I am Mayavadi, I am almost dead, try to save me. This sloka compiled, two sloka. He is speaking. On the basis of this sloka, two sloka, they want to prove, yes, Mayavadi is speaking himself. Who can speak? You have any evidence? You have any evidence? You can prove? That sloka was compiled by at all by Prabodhananda Saraswati Bhakti? Or at all it was compiled by him, you can show? Manuscript, you can show? 500 years back, 550 years back. Sometime Vaishnavas, they can out of the humble attitude, they express, I am useless, I am idiot. They can speak this. Like, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami is speaking. Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami is speaking. Puri, Jagai madai hoite muishe logishto, purisher kit hoite muishe Jagai madai hoite muishe papishto, purisher kit hoite muishe logishto. Mor naam jailai tar punnokhoi mor nai jailai tar paap hoy emon nighinno more keba kipa kore ek nitanand binu jagat ma jare. You can prove that Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami is worthless, useless. If you are a dry philosopher, you can have some concoction, you can conclude, oh, Maharaj, useless man, he is himself speaking, I am more fallen than a worm of a stool. So we can conclude. So foolish, you are doing bhajan perfectly. Who can say? I like to get evidence of Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami. I like to see the evidence of Bhakti Vinod Thakur. I have to show you. You will have to show me. You have to show documents by Jiva Goswami Pad, Rupa Goswami Pad, you have to show me. Then after that I can confess. I believe all our Guru Varga, they are in line. Follow? All they are in line. Sometime we are fighting among devotees. Bhano Goswami Maharaj, he was doing this kind of bhajan, he is not approved by Prabhupada. He is speaking, my Gurudev was doing this way, more than you. This is a fighting going on. They cannot harmonize. That Dikha Guru, Shiksha Guru, all the same. Only the point, you will have to harmonize. You will have to do deep bhajan. Go deep into the ocean of this spiritual life. There you can, in the ocean, one name of ocean. Ocean you speak in English. But in Sanskrit we say Ratnakar. In Sanskrit we say Ratnakar mean all jewels you can find inside the 20,000 league under the sea. 20,000 league under the sea you can find jewel, precious jewel there. That's why one name of Samudra, Samudra. One name of Samudra is Ratnakar. Follow? So you have to go deep. Out of a meditation, out of, you know, not that you can fight, you will have to follow the path shown by our Guru Bhargava. No concoction, no manipulation, I am not going to ready. Better I can leave my HariKatha, but still I am not going to change. One HariKatha Siddhanta gone out of is mean is evidence. Follow, like bow and arrow, one arrow thrown, is gone, out, it cannot come back. It cannot come back, this is called Siddhanta. Not that, Maharaj, it can be, this also can be. He said, no, Siddhanta is one and unique. Follow, what I say? This way, sometimes something, in different angle we discuss, Siddhanta can come back. You don't try to misuse this word. Sometime on different topics, we discuss from different angle, different Mahapurush, they indicating this can be this. But actually, Siddhanta is unique. Follow? So actually this way, you will have to go deep into the ocean of spiritual life. Then you can find jewel, you can harmonize. Guru Mukha Padma Bhakcho Hidayate Koriya Vaikcho Arna Koriya Mane Asha. I have no mood to fight with anybody. Believe me. But one by one I can give you argument, give you one by one. You will have to prove in favor of your unstable Siddhanta. In favor of your unstable Siddhanta, you will have to give documents. Follow? Some 12 years back, one Maharaj, old Maharaj, he is a disciple of Srila Bhakti to Madhav Goswami Maharaj. He respects me very much. Though he is aged, he is compiling one book, just copy from Sundaranda Vidya Vinod. And he wants to prove that we are not actually Madhav Gauriya Sampradaya. Usually, he show me his book. He give me scope to correct, edit. When I saw that book, Maharaj, what you have written? Your Guru Varga can cry, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Prabhupada and Madhav Goswami Maharaj. Yes, I am not going to change. We are actually not Madhav Gauri Sampradaya. He is not going to obey me. He likes to get his book edited by me. Many times I do it. Follow. Like Bhagavad Sakhatkar, everything, all top to bottom, editing and done. This is my Kipa. It's mine, not my capacity, but Kipa. But when actually he showed me this book, I said, oh my God, it's just a copy from Sundaranda Vidyavana. No, we are not actually Bibhu Panda, this, that, they are speaking this way. He said, he is not going to obey me. I am Maharaj, you can do one thing. I have no money, I cannot publish anything. You can do one thing, I am coming, I am going to Vrindavan, I can come back. Within this period, you check up this book. I can compile one Siddhanta, show that negative point you can put. Follow my point, what I mean to say, be careful. Negative point you can put, positive point, both. Like, you know, logical fighting? Like in court, this pleader speaking this, I can do one thing, I can give positive point, we are in favor of, you can, so that common people can understand both. Yes, yes, you are right. You come back from Vrindavan, you can wait up to that time. Yes, I can wait. I gone to Vrindavan. When I come back, I attend the Biraha function of Madhu Goswami Maharaj. After I deliver speech, everything, Sagar Maharaj also from, they are also coming. After my speeches were, somebody distributing book. This some book. I said, what book? They showing, I catch that book. Open the page at the same time, see, oh my God. He already published this book. He knew, oh my God. He published this book. This book is there with me, I can show you. You can cry. You can cry. Oh my God. I requested that, Maharaj, please wait. You can put negative, I can put, he is not waiting. Published. After that, in front of Madhav Goswami Maharaj Samadhi, I touch Samadhi, I took resolution, Maharaj, if I am your disciple, I am going to cut this point. Very shortly, I took resolution touching this Samadhi Mandir. And within 2-3 months, I compiled one book. There I put all documents. Very quickly I do. I like to republish this book and with all, you know, new thing I like to add. Who is going to those foolish people coming in front of you? Who can help me? Huh? They are busy with their rasatattva all the time. Who can help me? Nobody can help me. Follow? Then, I compile this book where already I wanted to prove that we are from Madhya-Gauriya Sampradaya. Who told we have no parampara? All I prove everything. Even with a letter, authentic letter by Prabhupad. Our parampara line. This book, if possible, Krishna permit, Gauranga, I can publish again in English. But I find nobody. Follow? And I give this book in front of him. Maharaj, dandavat unto your lotus feet, you read this book. First I go to him, pay to Madhav Goswami Maharaj, after my Guru Maharaj and Madhav Goswami Maharaj, Prabhupad, after that I gone, and keep this book in table. On table, Maharaj, you read this book, huh? Okay, please, never mind. It's not my own vanity. I compile all the Siddhanta by Bhakti Mata Prabhupada, everything. I pay Dandavat and come back. Till from then, I don't meet him. I don't meet him. This is all different kind of wrong Siddhanta coming us to put us all in trouble. Follow, we like to break line. Prabhupada also wanted to put so many documents here. Prabodhananda Parokhiya Madhurjya Rupasak is written by Prabhupada. Prabodhananda Parokhiya Rasaya. Can you read Bengali? It's a document by Prabhupada. Prabodhananda Parokhiya Madhurjya Rasaya Rupasak. Who writing Prabhupada? Who change? He cannot change heart. That's right. So one by one, Prabhupada give documents that we are not going to believe at all that Prakashananda, Prabhupadananda, same person. You have no power to prove. Even if you go to court, you cannot prove. You cannot tell. You can put some assumption. Assumption is not Siddhanta. Follow? Emotion is not devotion. Assumption is not Siddhanta. Follow? Many scientists before, when we were child like this boy, 5-10 years, we used to read, you know, science and this way. Avogadro's hypothesis. Newton theory. Now they want to prove all false. Newton theory you read? Now they want to prove all false. Follow? Light, about light theory. The modern science want to prove all false, useless. It's not right. They used to explain light. One straight line having no breadth, only length. Previously, 50 years, 10 years back, they used to speak. One straight line One straight line, having no breath, follow, only length. Previously, when we were a child, we used to read and pass in examination. Oh, he has come successful in exam. Follow. Only straight line definition is only length, no breath. Now, modern science speaking, it is not possible, foolish. If length is there, infinitesimal maybe, breath must be there. Follow. Like calculus, if you go up and if you do, you can find tens to zero, tens to infinity, calculus, higher mathematics. Tens to zero mean not zero, tens to zero, almost zero, not zero, has some value. Tens to infinity, not infinity. Infinity you cannot touch, but tends to infinity. Follow? One by one argument I can prove according to scriptural evidence. You will have to give answer. After that, I can stop my HariKatha and do Harinam and leave my body. I promise you. Follow? I can stop my HariKatha. You don't come to me. I don't like people come to me to disturb me. Follow? Unless if they are at all interested about bhakti, they can come. Otherwise, unnecessarily, I cannot waste my time. So you see, straight line they define this way. But at present, in school and college and school, they are taking one torch, you know, torch. They are right. The small boys there. You see the torch going, one pencil ray going, no existence at all. Pencil ray. A straight line. Follow? But previously what you are seeing, there is length, there is no breadth, it is not possible. If length is there, maybe very small, insignificant, but breadth must be there. You cannot count, you cannot measure, but breadth must be there. So this way all scientific research changing, all your mood changing, even you like to change, evergreen Vaishnava Siddhanta, you also like to change. Because now it's Kalikal. We like to change Siddhanta, but Siddhanta cannot be changed. Now actually, that is not completed as yet. That is typing going on. So you can give me all papers, I can compile everything, all sloka I speak to you. Now actually, about sannyasi, I am speaking sometime, that how is possible Bhaktivinoda Thakur was grihastha. Are Vishnupriya Devi sannyasi? How possible? Jannava Devi sannyasi? I already told you, maybe you cannot believe. That's why I like to quote this sloka. Geohi sa nitya sannyasi jo na deshti na kankhati. This sloka. From where? From Bhagavad 5th chapter, number 3 sloka. I quote it already many times. Gyohi sa nitya sannyasi jono adeshti na kankhati nirdando hi mahavaho sukham bandhat pramuchyate. Gyoho, you must know, gyoho sa nitya sannyasi jono adeshti na kankhati nirdando hi mahavaho sukham bandhat pramuchyate. 5 chapter, 3 slow. You can go. You can go to home and consult. Actually, they are automatically having renounce order inside their heart. Irrespective of their caste and creed and sex. Maybe they are woman, man, it matters little. Inside their head, total devotion there. Sannyas mean? Total devotion. Advaita Gosai, you want to prove Advaita Gosai grihastha. Well, he is grihastha. But at the same time, he is sannyasi. Totally he is, you know, dedicated to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So, grihastha still inside your sannyasi. This sloka speaking. Parjuna, who is free from the pairs of opposites, is easily free from bondage. Those who are nirdando means this material, you know, this opposite, this kind of, you know, what I say? This is called, Dondo means is fighting. And when you are getting equipoised situation, balance, then all your, you know, doubt, everything gone, then you can get the scope to throw yourself for the whole seva of Krishna. Gopikas, they are topmost sannyasi. No sannyasi in this universe, they can prove they are more than gopikas. Radhanani, topmost sannyasi. Infinity world, topmost sannyasi. Inside sannyasi, Radharani need not do tilak. He is always doing bhajan. No time. 24 hours, all the time. Painting, serving. There is secret Siddhanta, you see. Gyoho, sa nitya sannyasa. Nitya mane is ever sannyasi. Who is beyond this kind of, you know, danda problem. Is beyond. Who is totally dedicated unto the lotus feet of Supreme Lord. That day I quote one slok by Krishna, to Krishna speaking to Uddhav. You can remember? You can remember? Hari? That day already I speak. Nice sloka. Hmm? They actually want to book Gyanunishto Virakto Mad Bhakto Anapekchaka Salinganam Astamam Stakta Charit Abhidhi Gochara. Charit Abhidhi Gochara. They are beyond any rules. No rules can bind them, Paramahansa Gurudev. You can find some form. My Gurudev is naked. These, they are not naked. Oh, Paramahansa. They are busy with seva, not busy with material thing. So this stroke you can consult. Very nice commentary by Bhaktivinoda Thakur. This is that. Gyaho sa nitya sannyasi, jono deshti na kankhati, nirdando hi mahavaho, sukham bandhyat pramuchyate. Follow. And also, one evidence actually that I already gone through one Puran, maybe Padma Puran, also I forget, long ago. Maybe I forget, long ago, I read. They actually written that Vyasadev Goswami is sending Sukadev Goswami to whom? To Janak Maharaj. Now point is that I told you to stop your fighting because there was no time, that there is eternally they are present. It is true, eternally they are present. But actually in one, I forget that, I can search out. There I read that Vyasadeva Goswami is sending Sukhdev to get approval, unnecessarily. Whereas Vyasadeva Goswami is over-sanguine, that he is the topmost patra, pot, in which I can give. Now point is that when Vyasadeva Goswami took, you are putting argument, Vyasadeva Goswami in Dapar Yuga, who? Actually Ramchandra in Teta Yuga. But perhaps you forget, I discussed already in my Bhagavad discourse. Well, there is one chapter you can find. There is one chapter you can find, I mean, there is fourth and fifth chapter in Bhagavatam. I forget. There you can find, one by one, Sutadev Goswami, I mean, Parikshit Maharaj speaking, that is already quoted by Sutta. There is written, Sukadev Goswami is going to speak one by one. The avatara. Follow? Kurma avatar, Bada avatar, this avatar, gradually. One by one. Pay attention, very careful. One by one. Giving this avatar, after that this avatar, Chatushan avatar, Chatushan first avatar. Avatar means Shaktavish avatar, Ganavish avatar, Divina avatar, the first coming. Counting. While counting, in middle, speaking, then after that Parshuram. Parshuram. Huh? Parshuram gone. After the Purushanamavata is Shaktavesavata, Khatriya Shakti, Khatriya Shakti. You can find very easily, 16th number sloka, there you can find, it is written, I am reading, two or three sloka. Tataha saptadase yato satyavatyam parasarat Chakre Vedo Taraha Swakha Drishta Pungso Alpameda Saha. Naro Devatyam Apanno Surakarjo Chikilsaya Sumudro Nigrahadini Chakre Birjani Ataha Param. Mane first it is written, Vyasadeva Goswami took birth. Vyasadeva Goswami first came. After that Ramchandra came. Then you can fight. How is that possible? But in Bhagavata it is Jokhaman. First is counting Vyasadeva. After that counting, Ramchandra. After that counting, Ram, Krishna, Adi, Krishna, Balaram, everything. Now another slok is very important slok. You cannot fight with me, it is written that Dapare Samanu Prapte, it is written. In 7th or 8th chapter, I can quote. I forget to quote. Dapare Samanu Prapte Titiyo Yugo Pariyaye Yataha Para Sarat Yogi Vyasabhayam Kalaya Harehe. This slok, first try to concentrate your mind. It is written that when this Vyasadeva came about this direct document from Bhagavatam, it is written Dapare Samanu Prapte Titiyo Yuga Pariyaye. Dapare, so when Dapar approaching, mind it very careful. Dapare Samanu Prapte Titiyo Yuga Pariyaye Yataha Parasarat Yogi Vyasabhayam Kalaya Harehe. Vyasab, this is him. It is Parasarad. Parasar is the father of whom? Vyasadeva. Sattavati is the mother of Vyasadeva. Sattavati took birth from Uparichar Basu, one Gandharva, from his birja, sperm, falling down, and one fish, big fish, catching. From then, Sattavati took birth from a fish. That's why his smell is fishy. But actually he is Khatriya. Sattavati actually is the mother of Vyasadeva Goswami, is actually Khatriya. Follow a document in Mahabharata. I can give you a document. That is in from Mahabharata. Now point is that Sattavati Shuto, this is the Vyasadeva, about Vyasadeva it is in Dapare Samanu Prapte. Sam is Sanskrit, you split up. Sam Anu Prapte. Anu Prapte. When Dapar approaching, Dapar coming, not yet, then how I can calculate? Titiye Yuga Parjamene, this, the joint, you know, time of Satta Yuga and Teta Yuga. Teta Yuga and Dapar Yuga. Dapar Yuga and Kali Yuga. It is written, Maharaj, Titiye Yuga Parjamene, one Yuga gone, another Yuga entering, this is called, like, noon time gone, afternoon time, evening coming, this is called Sandhya. Follow? It's called Sandhya. Now point is that if you count this way, the Satyayuga gone. Satyayuga gone. Dapar-yuga, Satyayuga, Dap, meaning Satyayuga, Teta, Teta coming, this one. Teta gone, Dapar coming one. Dapar gone, Kali-yuga coming, you cannot tally. Maharaj, all we cannot tally. It is written Titiye Yuga Parjaya. How we can tally? Follow my point. Try to understand this point. Titiye Yuga Parjaya, if you calculate this way, Satyagyan Teta entering, this one junction. Tetagon Dapar entering, one junction. Dapargon Kali entering. You cannot tally. But where it is written Dapare Samanu Prapte, then how you can calculate? You have to calculate this way. Satya Teta Dapar Guli rotating. So you have to calculate this way. You count. You can calculate. Kali Yuga gone. Kali Yuga. Now Kali Yuga. Kali Yuga gone. Satya Yuga coming. One. Follow. Satya Yuga coming. Satya Yuga gone. Teta Yuga coming. Second. Teta Yuga gone. Teta Yuga entering. Third. Now we can tally. Now you can understand it is written, Dapare Samanu Prapte. Now you can tell it. You will have to calculate that way. Otherwise you cannot tell it. Bhagavad cannot speak lie. Dapare Samanu Prapte. When Dapar approaching. So how we can calculate? Where it is written, Vyasadev Goswami first took birth, after that Ramchandra. It is conclusion, and Siddhanta is that both Ramchandra and Vyasadev almost on same time came. As per Ramayana, Ramchandra came almost last time of the Tetaju. It is written, almost last. Tetaju going to be finished. That time Ramchandra came. And Vyasadev also came that time, almost that time. Even little bit before. Before. Now the son of Sukadev Goswami getting the darshan of Krishna inside Omba mother, you all perhaps you have heard. Inside the Omba. Vyasadeva Goswami for a long time he is inside Om. Vyasadeva Goswami, you come back, come out of Om. No, I cannot come. Kali can touch me. Because that time already Kali entered. Hello? Already big problem. Kali at the time, Kali Yuga actually Kali enter. That time also Vyasadeva Goswami is not speaking that Kali can touch me. Vyasadeva Goswami inside womb speaking, there is material life, I don't like to touch this material life. This much. In Purana it is there. Now point is that if at all when by the promise of Vyasadeva Goswami and Krishna then come back. Follow? Perhaps that time, perhaps who can say? Perhaps that time Janak Raja was still there. Mithila Janak Raja, actually Vidaha Raj, they are on long life there. Follow? You see? Like the brother of Ravana. Who? Who? Foolish. The brother of Rama, Ravana. Huh? Bibhishana. Bibhishana is still today there, living. You cannot see. In Kolapgam, Devapi, there also you can find. Satyabhama is still living. Satyabhamana. The son of, Dronacharya. Sasatthama. Aswatthama is also there, living today. But you cannot see. Still today, it is a fallacy in. Still today is the fallacy in Jagannath Mandir. One particular tithi, there they find one blue, totally blue color lotus onto the lotus feet of Balaram, Subhadra, and Jagannath. Still today, when the Panda open temple, they find fresh. Who is giving that? Bibhishana. One special tithi, every year. Still today you can find that in Badinaran, when first temple is being Akkhaya Tritiya day, when they open, they find as if somebody just finished his worship with fresh flower, lotus, everything, and smell of agaru scent. Just open, just somebody finish. Still today. Who worship? 6 months, 6 months, those demigods they worship, 6 months, the human being they worship. Don't try to express doubt in my speech. Follow. This way, actually, I like to finish today because time is very over. So, one by one I can discuss this point, one by one, so that at least you can find an indication, what is exact thing, what is the, exact Siddhanta. I am not going to manufacture Siddhanta in my brain. If my heart not supporting, Gurudev sitting inside, if my Gurudev not supporting, Prabhupada not supporting, he cannot support. You can kill me, but I am not going to support. Anyway, Vancha Kalpataruva Sekipasindibhaya Japatitanang Pavane Bhavishnava Bhyo Namo Namah.